part one of this series, we were able to swiftly debunk Marcus Allen's objection to the continuity of these two Apollo 15 photos. He didn't realise that not only did each astronaut have a camera, but that these two photos were taken with the same camera. Fortunately, for those of us who enjoy a good giggle at the Dunning-Kruger efforts of deluded conspiracy theorists, Marcus has kept on digging. Let's hear what he has to say now.
No. If you're going to photograph something like that, it's a very good photograph, by the way. Mm-hmm. It's called a pack shot, in technical terms, where you've got subjects of interest here, and that sort of leads you across through the flag, through the lander, through the rover. Your eye is taken across. You hardly need a caption. You know what you're looking at. Man on the moon.
Marcus thinks the photo is too well composed to have been taken by an astronaut in gloves on the moon. Before we have a look at the modifications made to the cameras to make them easier to use in gloves on the moon, let's remind ourselves of the two photos that Allen originally compared. AS-15-88-11863 and AS-15-88-11864. In Jim Irwin's photo of Dave Scott, we have Dave and the flag slightly above centre frame, the lunar module cut off by the edge of the frame, and the lunar rover is out of the frame altogether. The next frame is Dave's first photo of Jim, and the rover is cut in half by the edge of the frame. But wait, this isn't the photo that Allen shows us now. The picture that Allen shows is this one, AS-15-88-11866. We can see from the TV coverage that Scott, having taken 11864, moves a little bit further away to get the subsequent two shots, and it is the second of these that is the best. Marcus Allen has cherry-picked the one photo out of the three which he thinks can best support his already discredited argument that the Apollo photos are too good to be true. The video, which contains this and other claims about Apollo photos, shows clips like these of camera controls, as though these are the ones that the astronauts had to manipulate in their gloves. Well, guess what? They're not. The Hasselblad cameras were modified so that the control rings had large paddles that could be moved with gloved fingers, and there was an aiming arrow on top of the lens barrel. The shutter speed was fixed at 1/250th of a second. This, in conjunction with the speed of the film, was designed to correctly expose the surface of the moon. There was a choice of only three focus settings, near, medium and far, and the astronauts were trained to stand at the correct distance from the subjects. The wide-angle lens helped with framing, of course, but also, combined with a narrow aperture, produced a large depth of field, making it easier to keep things in focus. The astronauts practiced hard with these modified Hasselblads, and had their efforts in training assessed and criticised. They even took the cameras on holiday with them for extra practice. In this Apollo 16 training photo, Charlie Duke is using the sighting ring on the side of the 500mm camera to help him aim. It was amusing to see that Apollo detectives included an excerpt from a video of mine about Apollo 17 500mm photography, complete with my own red arrow pointing to the sighting ring. The long lens photography on Apollo wasn't very successful. A lot of the photos are motion blurred, but maybe Marcus can dig out an example of a 500mm photo that he considers too good to be true. Marcus thinks the famous Apollo 11 photo of Buzz Aldrin is also too good to be true. We'll be examining his claim about lighting in a later video, but for now let's just point out three obvious things in this photo that make it less than perfect. The top of Buzz's backpack is cut off by the edge of the frame. Clearly the camera was tilted, as the horizon isn't level. And parts of Buzz's spacesuit are obviously overexposed. I'll be concentrating on Alan's alleged area of expertise, photography, for the next few videos. But if you want to see just how badly he does when he tries his hand at the non-photographic aspects of Apollo, pop on over to the Phase 5 2012 channel.